What up, everybody? Welcome to the Al York Sports Show. Y'all already know, so much to do in so little time. The fastest or quickest 15 minutes of sports. Let's get right to it, man. Let's leave the bullshit for the bullshit, man. Let me start out by saluting the East Coast, West Coast, Midwest, Las Vegas, L.A., Dallas, London, LES to the death. You know I got a market. I got a market, man. That's how we do, man. And also, a special shout-out to Ray Shell. A special shout-out to Tony Mazzola, who's going to be a future sponsor for our show. And last but not least, my boy Michael Lemmer, security group. What up, homie? I told you I had you, man. And let's go right to NFL news. Like I said, so much to do in so little time. Let me get at it. Sad news in the NFL. We lost Cedric Benson due to a motorcycle accident. The guy was 36 years young. Cedric Benson, you know, decent running back. Played 3 years with the Bears. He opened up with the Bears. Played 4 years with the Bengals. And his last year with the Cheeseheads, the Packers. Benson played 96 total games, 1,600 rushes, 6,000-plus yards rushing, 3.8 average per carry, 32 touchdowns in 8 seasons. Salute and rest in peace to Cedric Benson. Let's go to NBA news real fast. Former NBA coach David Blatch was diagnosed with multiple sclerosis. I don't know the exact meaning of that, but I already know that shit ain't good. So to me, you know, I wish him the best. Quick recovery. And like I said, good luck, buddy. And whatever you have to do, make sure you do it. And other news. It's fight week. My boy Dwayne Beeman. You already know BD Beeman, a.k.a. Mr. Stop Running, a.k.a. El Chapo, a.k.a. Next up. His record is 16-1-1, but I say 17-0-1 because they robbed him in Mexico, and he did redeem that fight and broke the motherfucking nose and, you know, demolished him. So to me, he's 17-0-1 with 11 Ks. He's fighting Juan Francisco Estrada, who's 39-3. I call him Mr. Mexico. They love him in Mexico, Senor Mexico. He's going to have home field advantage. That's not a secret. But my boy is ready to go up in there and come out with the belt. That's how my man does it, man. My man Dwayne Beeman is the truth. I've been hollering at y'all for a long time about this guy. I remember when you guys was questioning me. Yo, who's this? I never heard of him. Yo, Al, what's going on? And now look where he at, man. He basically taking that belt away from being where he want to be at. And that's everybody wanting him because he loves that. He wants motherfuckers to want him. Like, come and get it type shit. Salute to Dwayne Beeman. Congratulations, brother. But you got one more thing to do. You got one more stop this Saturday, August 24th. Handle that business and take off, bro. You know what I mean? And another news, we going back to the NBA. I got a situation here where I'm a little befuddled. You know what I mean? I'm not a big fan of this guy, but, you know, we're going to talk about Carmelo Anthony. I know as I said it, a lot of y'all is like, Al, what? Al, you mentioning Melo? You guys got to understand, man. Melo wants to play another year. He proved it. He's working out hard. I heard he's been in the gym more harder than ever. I mean, why wait now? To me, like, you should, that's something he should have been had done, Melo. But when you got your so-called boy, LeBron, on the team, because LeBron be acting like that's his man's, how the hell does Jared Dudley get picked up before Carmelo Anthony? How is that possible? Both of them are on the latter stages of their career. Let me give you some indication of their stats. This is career-wise. Of course, this don't really apply to Melo because he's not this Melo no more. But let me just run through a few things. Melo's a career 24-point-per-game average, 6.5 rebounds, 3 assists type of dude. Chris Dudley averages 7.7 his whole career. Even his best years to his worst years, 7.7, 4.9 rebounds, 1.4 assists. Now, in a 2018-2019 season, you know, on the games that they did get to play, because Melo was basically out the whole season. Melo averaged 13.4, 5.4 rebounds and a half assists a game. When Dudley was 4.9, 2.6, 1.4. Moral of the story, Melo's a way better fit than Jared Dudley. Way better fit than him. Better player than him. Even right now that Melo's like the worst Melo you can get. He's a spitting image of himself. But that's an insult to pick up Jared Dudley instead of Melo. That's such an insult, man. Like, I'm to the point where I'm really convinced that the NBA is blackballing him. But I hate to use that terminology because you're riding on slippery ice with that. Because now, for every time a guy doesn't get signed, are we going to say that he's getting blackballed? Because that's like the hating shit. All because you don't like a guy or agree to his performance being as great as other people indicate. Why should I make you a hater? I mean, we speak the truth be told. The raw truth. I mean, and it also depends on how you come across shit. Like when I made that video against Vegas Dave, a lot of people understood where I was coming from. So they was like, you know what? You keeping it 100, though. I can fuck with you. But then you had like maybe 8% that was like, yo, you a hater, man. You got that nigga's fucking name in your mouth. I'm a hater for getting at a dude that disrespected me. To me, he disrespected me by not answering my phone calls after we had an agreement. And I go and check him, and I politically said everything correct. And I made sure I implicated the good, the bad, and the ugly. I didn't just say all negative shit. If anything, I gave him the highest props you can give somebody. I say he's one of the best marketers in the game. Now, the so-called brothers that call me haters, y'all forgot to hear that shit, right? The only thing you heard is when I was breaking down those facts that were actual. Now I'm a hater because I'm the one exposing it, right? Fuck out of here, man. Y'all niggas got to get your... Yo, a lot of y'all dudes shouldn't even talk, man. Like, if y'all dudes don't know what it is, y'all shouldn't even have the right to talk, man. Because that's real talk, man. But back to Melo. I think he deserves another chance. Of course, he's going to be a bench player. I think he could be bench help. I think he's right now better than any bench player that the Golden State Warriors got. I mean, you could go through a bunch of teams. And the fact that he's willing to become a bench player and be a bench player should give him the right to get back in the league. Now, it's different if he's one of those cats that's like, yo, if you don't start me, I'm out of here. No. Melo already turned that down. Melo ain't on it like that. Melo just wants to make the team and get some minutes. He don't care about that starting shit no more. He sacrificed that knowing that his game fell off. He knows his game fell off. But because it fell off doesn't mean he's the worst player in the NBA. Like even Steven Jackson pointed it out. Melo's still better than 50% of the NBA players. To me, that's kind of steep. I probably would have said 36-40 because I've seen his drop off. But Melo should have a job if he's looking for work, is what I'm saying. And LeBron James, I'm so disappointed in you, dog, because if this dude is your man, you know he's hurting, man. And all he's going to do is come off the bench for you guys. He ain't stealing no shine. He ain't being out there with the starters. And if he happens to find himself and be somewhat the old Melo he used to be, that can only help you guys get a championship even quicker. All right? And with that, I'm going to my next subject, man. Stop hating on Melo, NBA. Now, we're going to make this quick. Like I said, so much to do in so little time. We're going to the MLB standings. If you hear things sound like the same, you got to work with me because every fourth, fifth day, I'll give y'all this to give y'all exactly where we at. Yankees still 10 games up. We're going to the next subject. Twins are 2 games up on the Tribe, 76-49. With about 36, 35 games left, that's going down to the wire. Even though I think the Twinkies, we squeeze it out. And I think the Tribe would get the wild card spot. And I'm saying, both Sox, A's, it's not happening. Chris Sale, is out for the season. They're thinking Tommy John, and I hope he doesn't do Tommy John because that means he might be another 2 years out. I'm hoping he can get over the injury without having to do Tommy John, but regardless of the fact, he's going to be out at least a whole season now and maybe even next year. And as far as the West, A's made it interesting. When the Astros lost something like 5-7 in a row, A's got hot, beat them the first two games in Oakland at the Coliseum, and then they lost the last game, and then the Astros won on Monday night. So they actually could have got down to 5.5-6 games, but by losing on Sunday, that real good game they played, now they're down back to 8 games, and I think that was Oakland's chance, if they had any, to win that division. But they still can get the wild card, but I just think the Tribe is too good. And they got Carrasco coming back, and I think somebody else is coming back. I forgot who it was, but I know definitely Carrasco's on his way back. I don't know if it's Salazar or another pitcher, but I know they got somebody else coming back. So the Tribe will win the wild card or the division, in the either or. Twinkies and them are going to play each other for that wild card game. Now, nationally, Atlanta Braves. The Braves are 5 games up on the Nationals. Nationals playing stout ball. Like I said, if they had a closer, they'll be in first place. They one of the worst teams in baseball to close out games. You know what I mean? And y'all seen them blow game after game after game, especially when Doolittle blew that league against Milwaukee Brewers the other day, 11-8. They still had a chance to steal it, and they lost that game. Those games would come back and haunt them later on positioning. So even if they get the wild card, they're going to probably be on the road on the wild card. Why? Because you're losing those games that could have had you at home. And who knows? If you would have won, let's say, 15 of them games you had in Leon, you probably could be having home field advantage in round one. But since you're blowing saves and you keep getting these bums, and, you know, Doolittle ain't the answer, you picked up a couple of other guys, you know what I'm saying? And these guys is just not delivering. You let a lot of good closers go, from training to Kinsler. You know, you had a lot of guys that could have really helped y'all, and y'all let them go, and you decided to ride with Doolittle, and he's not doing the job. That's bottom line. Now, National Central, the Cardinals are up a half a game on the Cubs. Also, let me check the wild card situation. Hold up, give me a minute. Nationals are up 2, and then they're up 2 games on the Cubs for the last spot. No, the last spot is going to be the Cubs and the Nationals. But if the Cubs want that home game, they're 2 games behind the Nationals to play that game at home. And then you got the Phils 2 games out of the last spot. Mets 2 games out of the last spot. Milwaukee 3 games out of the last spot. Giants 3.5 games in the last spot. And the D-backs are 4. Forget about the D-backs, because the reason why I'm forgetting about the D-backs is because they traded Greinke. And like I said, they're not going to make it if they gave Greinke up. That was big for them. And they really fucked up on that, man. All right? So with y'all guys, this is Al York Sports. Thank you for tuning in for another session. Salute to Syndicate Radio TV, Noah Parker, my whole crew, everybody for believing in me. I love y'all, man. And this song makes perfect sense because this is my best movie ever, man. And with that, y'all hold your head. LES to the death. Las Vegas. Love y'all, baby. Al York Sports.